I am in a lovely film called Followers, which is part of Fright Fest. I'm so excited that we got into Fright Fest because it's such a special thing to be a part of. It's my first ever comedy horror genre kind of film. I was very nervous about doing it. And the first time I did one of the gory scenes, I got to tell you, my knees gave way and I fell to the ground. I'm not good with blood. Why am I here?
We're here at Fright Fest with people who do love horror. Why do you think that is? Why is the genre so passionately followed?
Horror has a real loyalty factor to it. You know, I think if you enjoy horror, you stay loyal to the genre. My own son, who is obsessed with it, I think he started watching horror films because my husband's a big fan. And so from a very young age, you know, he looks forward to the next thing that's coming out. It's kind of like, it has its own set of fans and nothing will kind of, you know, take that away. So I think you guys are very lucky with Fright Fest because not a lot of other movies, you know, other genres have that kind of following.
One of the projects you're involved with coming up has a huge long-term following with Sandman. Is it possible you can tell us a little bit about how you feel to be involved in that project and what fans of that amazing graphic work can expect from the live-action version?
Sure. Neil Gaiman is a legend. and the fact that they've decided, you know, to take his stories and put them on Netflix is just wild. When my husband found out, because he had all the original comics, when my husband found out, it was possibly the most exciting thing that happened in the house. And I went up to play Mother Fate, and when I got it, it was just crazy. It's just to be a part of something that huge, because that, again, has its own following. Anyone, you know, Neil Gaiman's graphic novels are incredible. So that's coming out hopefully next year. We've shot quite a few scenes. It's the first time I've been in prosthetics for so long, or just, you know, the outfits, everything about it is superb. I think people will love it.
And I think for people who maybe aren't as familiar with the source material, can you tell us just a little bit more about your character? Because obviously she's part of a trio, which forms quite an important crux of the stories.
Well, the trio are kind of all powerful, and the Sandman does have to answer to them. So it's quite interesting, the dynamic, because, I mean, he's the main character, he's the lead in it. And so there's these three women of, you know, there's the maiden, the mother, and the crone. And they, you know, he comes to them for help at some point in his time. So it was quite nice to be able to play that kind of all-powerful being. It's special.
And I think, obviously, Tom, as our lead, is a very exciting young performer. Can you talk a little bit if you had a chance yet to work with him and how he's embodying that very iconic character?
Well, Tom Sturridge is just, he's got a very dreamlike quality about him, just naturally. And luckily, one of our first scenes was with him. So that was quite special to play. He's also a generous actor, which is, you know, really important when you're working together like that. Now, one of our first scenes was set in a quarry to have this dreamlike quality. It was in February, it was freezing cold, and we were in this long sort of chiffon outfit. And we had a wind machine on top of that to boot. So it was a very cold day, and Tom was lovely because he stood on a chair and shouted his lines to cue us. So he's a lovely actor, and I think he's going to blow up after this.
And I think from what we've seen, the very brief kind of making of footage they've released, it feels like a lot of the sets are very practical, almost to a surprising extent. Can you talk a little bit about that element of the production?
The sets were very interesting. I think they've gone for very specific themes for almost each of the episodes to reflect certain times during the graphic novel. So there are some interesting choices that have been made, but I think it'll be down to the performances to lift up the level of the actual show.